Hi everybody. So by far the most popular video on the Reflactor channel is the how-to video that I made on how to use these popular cell phone adapters for telescopes. I suspect that's because they seem to come with every telescope nowadays and everybody has one. And I've used one for years and to be honest, they work really well. In fact, I've taken pictures like this and this and this. However, you can't stop progress and there's a new adapter in town. It's called the Celestron NexYZ. And in this video, I'm gonna show you how it works, how to set it up, how to set up the software on your camera app, and how to fix a common issue with this adapter, and most importantly, who should and should not buy the Celestron NexYZ. You can buy the Celestron NexYZ adapter online for about $65. So what do you get for $65? Let's take a look. There's a foam lid, and there's a bag, and in the bag, you get the NexYZ adapter, okay? In all of its glory, right? You get a set of paper instructions. I'll be demonstrating this in the video, so if you want, you can still read these, right? In several different languages. And you also get a couple of adapters here. I guess this is if you have some of the older eyepieces. I have an example here. These were really popular, I guess, a while ago in the 80s and 90s on essentially the lower cost telescopes that you could buy at department stores. So this would be an adapter somewhat for these. It would need to be a bit longer. If you've watched my other adapter video, you know that I always start out the process with mounting the eyepiece first in the adapter. It's relatively simple, but there is a trick. For example, when you first get this, you might notice, wow, that spring tension is not very tight. In fact, you might just think it just clamps down on like that, but that is way too loose. In fact, if you were to set this on here like that, it would probably fall off and it would destroy your expensive phone. So no, we don't do it that way. The key to the Celestron NexYZ is that it doesn't rely on spring tension alone. Instead, there's actually a reddish nut right here that we use to tighten it down every time. It's very important that you tighten this down every time. So here's how it works. You take the eyepiece, you put it in here, you let it clamp down where you think it should go, and then you tighten this nut sufficiently tight so that the eyepiece is in there pretty rigidly. That's actually not going to go anywhere. Now, you may have already noticed, actually, when I was setting this up, that the spring has quite a bit of range. Look at that. And this is actually really nice, especially if you have large eyepieces. Here, example, is the 2-inch. And it fits on there pretty nice. You still need to tighten that nut, okay? If you are fans of the Explore Scientific 82-degree eyepieces, these things are pretty awesome, then you may have noticed that these don't fit in the old traditional affordable, I guess, or cheap cell phone adapter. This is kind of one of the cons for using this. It doesn't fit the Explore Scientific barrels. So it doesn't fit, right? And it especially doesn't fit the 30 millimeter eyepiece, at least, you know, not without some dynamite. But then again, neither does the Celestron NexYZ. Now, oddly enough, the Celestron NexYZ can fit a lot of the larger eyepieces, but the one thing it can't really handle is if you have really short, stubby eyepieces. You're going to run out of gripping room on the barrels here if you try to put this in there. It's one of the pros of the old cheap version is that this actually works pretty well. But anyways, we're talking about the new adapter here. Okay, so you've got the eyepiece clamped in. Now for the easy part. There are three grabbers on this that will pinch your cell phone. Two of these are fixed. They're not going to move. This third one is spring-loaded. So just take your cell phone, pull the spring-loaded part out, and put the phone in, and just make sure it is put in the right spot, like that. It's just that easy. So there you go. Just load your cell phone in. It's pretty grippy. Just, you know, be reasonable about it. Now getting the camera lens lined up with the eyepiece, that's the tricky part, usually. But it's pretty easy with this adapter. The Celestron NexYZ has all the adjustments you need to make it very simple. Let me show you. There are three adjustment knobs. Let's call them the X and Y, and then there's the Z. This Z axis is the one that I had problems with, but Celestron tech support was pretty awesome, and I'm going to demonstrate how I tighten that up later on in this video. The first thing I need to do is adjust the Z axis so that the rubber cup of the eyepiece is touching the cell phone. That's a good place to start. So you just turn the knob until that gap closes. See, that's going farther away. Bring it up like that. Now, the reason we want to do that is because it's going to basically close this gap and make sure that no, for example, outside lights, any street lights, can get in here and mess up the image. It also puts the camera lens right about where your eyeball would be, so it helps with focus a little bit. But how do you get the camera lined up perfectly, at least this way and this way? The first step is to turn on the camera app. All right, so this is what you might see when you first start it up. And again, there are two knobs stacked on the bottom, and these are going to control the side-to-side and forward and backward motion of the camera relative to the eyepiece. So let's get the forward lined up first, and that's this big knob. There, that's a good first guess. Now we're going to do side-to-side, which is the middle knob. And look at that. Now, I've hit the extreme edge movement on this adjustment. I'll talk about how that could possibly be a limitation for some people. Most likely, it won't be. So, all in all, that was actually really easy. That's much simpler than lining up one of these old adapters. While we're here, I do need to touch on something that might be a problem for some of you. That side-to-side movement is limited. So for people that have cell phones that are in the upper corner, right here, that won't be a problem. So for example, all the Apple iPhones out there, you have all the adjustment in the world, you're going to be able to use the heck out of this adapter. However, if your camera is right in the middle of this, as it is on this particular phone, then I was pretty much at the side-to-side limit adjustment that I could get out of this adapter. In fact, and actually I might not have had enough. I might have been just actually a little bit off. If my phone were any wider and the camera was in the middle, I might not actually be able to get it lined up with the eyepiece. I did some calculations, and if your camera is in the middle of your phone and your phone is wider than about 3.3 to 3.4 inches, you may actually run into this side-to-side travel limitation. Of course, all is not lost. If your phone is still in the case, then you just remove the case and that'll actually buy us some space back on this adapter. But again, you know, I think this is probably a pretty rare situation, but I did want to point it out just in case you have a very large phone with a camera right in the middle. To take the best pictures, you're going to need to do some basic setup on your camera app. Okay, so I'm going to show you the basic setup for the phones. All right, so this is the Samsung Galaxy S9 Plus. I'm going to show you how I set it up for astrophotography. Of all the options, I click on the More button, and I go to the Pro option. And this brings up some of the more important things. Cameras are amazing these days. They can pretty much guess what you want to focus on. There's only one problem. If you point one of these up into the sky, it doesn't know how to focus. In fact, it starts hunting for focus, going in and out, blurry, far, near. So what we're going to do is, since we're trying to take pictures of things that are millions of miles away, we are going to make sure we use manual focus, and we're going to make sure it's focused on infinity. That's sometimes represented by, mountains or a tree or something like that. You don't want it to focus on the flower. That means you're manually focusing on something really close. We want to focus on far away. So set the manual focus to infinity if you have it. Now, the other two important settings that you have are the ISO setting, that's the light sensitivity, and the shutter speed, which is in basically fractions of a second. Now, on this phone, the ISO goes from 800, which makes it super sensitive to light, and 50, which makes it super dark. If you're taking the picture of a very bright object like the moon, you can get away with setting the ISO pretty low. If you're trying to take a picture of, say, Jupiter, you might want to put it in a middle range between, 250, 350, something like that. Now, the other control that you have is the shutter speed. Now, this goes from 1/6,000th of a second all the way up to 10 seconds. And you can see that, in a way, this it basically controls how long the image is exposed to whatever you're taking, and it just keeps gathering light. So, for example, when I take pictures of the International Space Station, that thing's moving pretty quick. So I have to set the shutter speed to at least 1/350th of a second. And of course, I turn the ISO up a little bit just to capture it. The space station, as it turns out, is pretty bright. So that's usually not a problem. So again, the three things that you have to control somehow on your particular camera app are, if you have manual focus, set it to infinity, play with the ISO light sensitivity settings, and then shutter speed, you have to make that judgment on what you're trying to photograph. So that's really all there is to it. All right, now let's get this into focus. There we go, nice full moon. I actually have a 15 millimeter eyepiece, and on this particular telescope, that will show you just barely the whole full moon. One thing to keep in mind is I have a sliding counterweight back here. When you put the heavy camera and the adapter on the front, this thing may want to tip down. So you're going to have a counterweight or some way to basically counteract all that heavy weight up front. But let's get this centered and let's see if we can take some pictures. Make sure it's in focus. It's pretty sharp. I'm going to take a picture. I'm going to take a picture. All right. Now if I want, I can zoom in. Zoom in on the crater up there. Remember, this is everything's upside down because the way this telescope shows things. Take a picture of the crater. Awesome. You can play with the ISO light sensitivity settings. You can play with the shutter speeds. You get darker and lighter. I'm going to set it at 3000 for now. Okay, so we need to have a talk. I did have one issue with this adapter. Now, your experience may be different, but when I got it, the adjustment axes were actually really loose, especially the Z-axis. It was downright sloppy. In fact, the Z-axis was actually kind of bent. So I contacted Celestron's tech support, and they pointed me to some online instructions for tightening things up. Here's the printed out instructions. I'll have a link to the online version of this down in the description. As it turns out, each of the three axes actually has two screws that can be turned very carefully to tighten up the axes. The key word is carefully. Do not over tighten them. And make sure to use the right size screwdriver and go slowly. Only turn them a little bit at a time and check for tightness on each of the axes. I'll point them out here. Here are the two screws for the Z-axis. Here are the two screws for the side-to-side. And I believe here are the two screws for the forward and backwards. Okay, so what is it actually doing when you tighten these? When you tighten those little screws, it pushes against this little wedge here that gets squeezed against the dovetail, and it actually makes each of the axes a little bit harder to move. So you got to be careful though, because this is threaded plastic or nylon or whatever that material is. So make sure you don't over tighten it. You can strip this, so be very careful. I had to take this one step further because, and I wouldn't go so far as to say this is a design flaw at all, but my Z-axis wouldn't tighten up or get straightened up, no matter what I did. It just stayed loose, quite a bit loose. And after doing some troubleshooting, it came down to one of these adjustment screws actually being too short. And it's kind of a weird thing that happened. So this particular screw, the head of it was bottoming out on the body of this plastic before it could reach its full extension on the wedge that it was pushing down. Now this front screw, that's fine. That wasn't a problem. So I found kind of a simple trick around that. I actually took this one out and I replaced it with a longer screw. Again, be very careful. You do not want to over tighten these. By the way, this is a M2. These are metric machine screws. This one is 10 millimeters long. And of course, when you get to the point where you can feel just a little bit of the tension, you want to start testing it and see if it's still wobbling. So let me tighten this one just a little bit. And remember, just tighten them a little bit. Very, very careful. One note of warning, doing this might actually void the warranty. It's the exact same threads, it's just a slightly longer screw. But just, you know, proceed at your own risk, because this plastic can be stripped. The threads can be stripped, so just be very careful. Don't over-tighten it. But as you can see, this is really tightened up now. Okay, so let's recap with some of the pros and cons of the new Celestron NexYZ. This is not a cheap accessory, so who should buy it? Well, if you have eyepieces that are kind of the standard size down in the 30 millimeter diameter range to maybe 40 millimeter diameter range, you can probably get away with one of the more affordable, cheap adapters. And of course, one of the other side benefits of these is that they fit the short, stubby eyepieces. However, if you want a super fast way to attach and detach your cell phone, and also if you have larger barrel eyepieces like the 82 degree Explore Scientific series, or even some of the standard 2-inch eyepieces. And of course, don't forget the super fast alignment process. Then I highly recommend the Celestron NexYZ. Just remember a few things. Don't rely on the clamp pressure alone to hold everything together. You need to tighten that nut. Again, if the axes are sloppy when you're adjusting them, go ahead and take a look at the online recommendation instructions from Celestron. Again, the link is in the description down below. And lastly, if you have a larger phone and the camera is right in the middle, then if you know somebody that has one, maybe you can give it a try and see if it works. But other than that, I give it 2 thumbs up. This is a pretty neat little bit of engineering here. So please push the like and subscribe button. It means the world to these videos and helps me bring more of these videos to you. Thank you for watching. And of course, go ahead, no matter what adapter you have, put an eyepiece in it, take it outside, and go take some awesome pictures of the night sky. Clear skies, everybody. So be sure to push the like and subscribe button. And please, if you want, please recommend this channel to anybody you know that likes telescope accessories and telescope advice. So again, clear skies, everybody.